I'm from the Dominican Republic. I came over here to the States when I was 9 and a half, 10. I live in Dorchester. My dreams and my career, like everything. My life is boxing. That's what I do. I started boxing when I was 14. I never thought I would do it. Like, I just came to the gym with a couple of friends. And I stayed, and I loved it. In middle school, a couple of my friends wanted to box. And I told them, I'm like, all right, I know of a gym in Dorchester I could bring you to, but I'm not gonna box. I just bring you, and that's it. And I'm leaving, because I love, like, being outside. Like, I used to love the streets, like, playing basketball, being with my friends, just being outside, hanging out. I was the type of kid that was, like, 10 in the morning outside, and at 10 at night, still outside. My mom looking for me, come eat or something, you know, like, I used to love the streets. So a couple of my boys, one of them, Giovanni, he died 2 years ago, rest in peace. Eric, and another kid, I don't remember his name right now, it was all four of us. We went to the gym, and one by one, they started, like, slacking, like, just leaving. And then I just stayed. Giovanni stayed a little longer with me, too. He stayed, like a year. But then eventually he stopped too. And then I just stayed. I just work at it. I just do it. Like, I love working. I love working out. I work hard. I love getting better. Boxing is the type of sports. It's really hard. Cause it's only you. You have nobody else to play. It's you in there by yourself. So every mistake, everything you do is you. And it's difficult because everything surrounding you affects boxing. Like, everything bad happening in your life affects boxing. Everything good affects boxing. Like, it's very strange how it works. Like, sometimes your body feels good. Sometimes, like, your body don't feel good. Sometimes your mind is not there. Everything has to, like, click. Like, you have to make sure it clicks the day of the fight. Or you have to try to click the day of the fight. It wasn't like a dream or anything. I just did it. I didn't even know why or how, but I just kept coming to the gym. I just kept going to the gym. Martin kept getting me fights. He was the one that believed me. He was the one that brought me, like, to fights. When I started believing in myself was one time they called up Martin and they say, oh, we have an extra ticket to go to a tournament in Kansas City. It was a ringside tournament, world ringside tournament. So people from every country, every part of the states go up there to fight. I was 15 years old. It was 2005. I had like a year maximum boxing, like a year. And Martin said, yeah, I have a kid, so give me a ticket. So we went up there and I won the whole thing. And I was really happy and proud of myself. And that's when Martin started, like, really, really believing in me. And I started believing in myself, and we started going to tournaments all over the country. Like, we started going to Florida, he brought me to Vegas, he brought me to Miami, like, he brought me everywhere. And we won a lot of those tournaments. And it was good. And then I knew I had it. Like, I wasn't afraid of fighting nobody. Like, I wanted to fight the best out there. Like, at that point, I was like, I could do this. Like, even if they beat me, I know I just have to work a little harder to beat them. Like, I just need, like, a little bit more experience and I could beat them. So all those tournaments, it was amazing. He brought me with his own money, which God is gonna pay him one day, because right now I can't. Or maybe I will in the future. But he brought me to all those tournaments with his money, bought me tickets, bought me food, hotel, and we won a bunch of them, and it was good. He's like a second father to me. His family's like a second family to me. He's more than just a coach to me. Like, maybe if he dies, I stop boxing, maybe. Or maybe, like, I wouldn't box without him. Like, it's that tight of a relationship. When I came here, I came with my mother, and we had a 10-year visa. So after 6 months, if you don't leave the country, that expires. You, like, leave it. Oh, you are illegal, you know what I mean? So, I was basically illegal, but I was still going to school. I still didn't understand, like, everything what was going on, like, legal issues. I just, like, did my own thing, like any kid. And, so, like, the first couple of weeks, or the first couple of months, Martin gave me, like, a sign-up sheet. Like, my mom to say, okay, that I could buy, like, all this. So when I go, like, home and read it, he says you have to be like a citizen and all this. So I'm reading it, and I got really sad, cause I'm like, damn, I'm not a citizen. Like, I can't box anymore. It wasn't really like a couple of weeks into boxing. I was like, damn, I can't box anymore. It was very like bad for me. So I went to I was scared to go back, cause I thought I was gonna get in trouble. Like, Martin was gonna call the police or something. So that was the first experience with like my legal status, like where I was like really scared of getting like in trouble or getting my first thing was getting my mom in trouble. I was afraid of that. Like, I didn't really care about me because I was only a kid, but I didn't want to get my mom in trouble. So then in the tournaments, it was very frustrating because it was like a bunch of Golden Gloves that I couldn't like participate at all, and I couldn't because I wasn't legal. Because I didn't have my citizenship, or I wasn't a permanent resident. So it was very frustrating, because I know I could beat some of those kids. Oh, if I didn't beat them, I could do really good, and like, the year after beat them, or just keep getting better. I feel like that limited me, like my potential too, to keep getting better. But I believe in God, and I believe that everything He does is for a reason. So maybe I wasn't meant to participate in those tournaments. In 2010, I got my green card. So they gave me permission to participate. They said, all right, you could go in the gloves and low. So I said, I was really happy. I was like, yeah, I have to go hard. I have to really work hard at this. It's my first Golden Gloves. I have to show people that I could have won this all these other years. That I was this good. So I did, and I won the whole thing. It was a good tournament. I had like six fights, and I won the whole thing week after week. And then a couple of like weeks passed, and Yvonne, Martin's wife, told me, oh, I have bad news for you. They're not gonna let you go to the Nationals. The Nationals is the tournament that you go to after you win the Golden Gloves. So I was like, I was really down on myself. Like, damn, like, I just won the whole thing, and they're not gonna let me go. You know, like now that's like, that was really frustrating for me. I'm young, but I feel like already, like, everybody that knows me, they know me for being a worker, for working hard. I love working hard, I love getting better. And that's, I feel like that's how I am gonna be remembered. It's not how I want to be remembered. That's how I am gonna be remembered. I'm gonna be remembered as, oh, Gary, that kid worked hard. You know, like, I'm a worker. That's like, that's what I do. I just love working. I love getting better. And that's how I'm gonna be remembered someday. Like, I'm normal. I'm like anybody else. You know what I mean? Like, I'm like you. I'm like you. I love partying. I love girls. I love everything. Like, I love cars. I love everything that like a guy loves. But when I'm in the gym, it's like all of that go out the door. Like, all I leave that outside. Like, I just work and focus on this. I just want to get better and better at it. Like, every time I don't have a good day in the gym, I want to work harder, and I want to just get better and don't make the same mistakes I made before, and keep working hard and get better and better. But it's tough, because it's like a balance, because your body only takes so much, and you need to rest your body enough, and you need to, like, it's a very thin balance, which I'm trying to still, like, find it. I'm still working to find it. Like, when do I have to stop not working out? Like, when do I have to rest? Because I love working out. I love getting better. It's just hungry, like, just to get better and better. Like, that's it. That's why I work hard. Like, that's why I keep working. Right now, I'm even, like, just more hungry. Like to get better and like, just see where this takes me. Like, how far I could go. Celebrity, my man caught a body allegedly, so much for longevity, and you can't change the past, gotta let it be. My flow ill and they ain't got a remedy. It's like we immune to the drama.